Hello, my name is Chris Ringstaff and I'm coming to you from the beautiful suburbs of Austin, Texas. This is my video submission for the online public archaeology week sponsored by the Society for American Archaeology. My topic today is what archaeologists learn by making and using stone tools. As an experimental archaeologist, I make and use stone tools to better understand observations that I see at archaeological sites. So today, I thought I would do a brief demonstration of flint knapping to help you better understand how ancient people made stone tools and how I use the experiments that I conduct to better understand archaeological materials. So let me just get started. Okay, so this is a piece of flint, and living in Texas, there's quite a bit of it depending on where you live. This pretty much just looks like a rock, but it actually has very high silica content, and I won't digress into the geology of that. Now here is a tool that I call a hammerstone. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to strike the piece of flint and take a look inside and see what the quality is like. Now, I want to add that these are safety glasses, and for any of you youngsters, please don't try this at home. It's very dangerous. Okay, so here we go. All right, so there we go. So it's a really nice piece of flint, very glassy, and being glassy, it has a very sharp edge. So I'm gonna go ahead and strike it a couple more times. There we go. And there's our sharp edge right there. Now, so this piece now has become what I call a core. And these pieces that are coming off are called flakes. Okay, and so some of these flakes will actually be used as tools, and some of them are just debris from the manufacturing process. So, now just to demonstrate how sharp this is, and this is always a crowd pleaser, I'm gonna take this flake and I'm gonna cut this piece of leather. All right. Oh yeah. And there it is. So, very sharp. So you can see that just in a few strikes I was able to make a very sharp stone tool. Now, there's a lot of different kinds of stone tool manufacturers. So here's one type of core, and here's another type of core. This is a larger core that I may carry with me because it's relatively light. It is kind of big, so I can remove big things off of it. And rather than striking it with a rock, I'm going to actually use a different material. I'm going to use a piece of elk antler, and I'm going to strike it right here and see if I can detach a piece. And there we go. So once again, it's a nice sharp flake that I can use as a stone tool. And so as an experimental archaeologist, I can take pieces like this and use them for all manner of different cutting or scraping experiments, and then look at them under the microscope and see what kinds of traces of residue or wear are left on them. So that's the essence of experimental archaeology. I do experiments. Now, in this particular case here, we have some actual archaeological material. So here you can see there's a dart point, and I'll explain a little more about that shortly. And here are a bunch of the tiny chips that were made in the manufacture of what we believe to be, you know, other dart points. So now, how do we know this? Well, through the process of experimental archaeology, I generate my own chipping debris, or sometimes we call it debitage, in the process of making my own stone spear points. So you can see in this particular case how that guy would fit on there. And then I can attach them, and much like the archaeological specimen, I ground the edge so that these bindings won't be cut. And I'll just tie that guy on. We'll just do this real quick. All right. Probably spend a little bit more time, but you get the idea. And there it is. So now I can make a number of these, and then I can use them for cutting or throwing and make observations on the different kinds of damage that I see on the ends of these things, and not have to ruin archaeological specimens, but also compare them with archaeological specimens to get a better understanding on what they were used for. So that is the essence of experimental archaeology. So just to wrap things up, I'm gonna make a couple more stone tools. So what I'm gonna do is, using the core we were using earlier, I'm gonna strike another piece off. There we go. And I'm gonna take a deer antler billet, and I'm gonna shape this to make a special kind of tool called a scraper. Oh, now there, it just broke on me, but I think actually that's gonna work for me. Okay. So that's a kind of tool that I can make pretty quickly. So that's just an end scraper, and you can see how I've beveled the edge down. And this is for scraping hides in a process like this. Sometimes they may take the scrapers and put them on a stick so you don't, your hands don't get tired. And so as an experimental archaeologist, we can use these and scrape a lot of different materials with them and see what kinds of dulling and scratches it leaves on the end, and then compare them to real scrapers that we find in archaeological sites. Well, I think that'll do it for today. It's just gonna be a short video, and I wish we had more time. Thank you, and I hope you learned something today. Be safe out there, and it's my pleasure talking to you.